One should not confuse activity for progress. Hey, I'm Nivya, and today I'm going to review and also speak about the content in the book Veerappan Chasing the Brigand by K. Vijayakumar. Most of you would be aware of who Veerappan is. He was a bandit who used to kidnap people, especially politicians, for ransom, that's for making money. He was also involved in sandalwood smuggling and poaching, that is illegal hunting of elephants. He had killed around 2,000 to 3,000 elephants and around 120 people. And these people mainly were policemen, then the forest officials and informants, or the people whom he thought at least were informants. You can understand how difficult it would have been for the government to capture him when I say that it took around 100 crore rupees for the government to capture and kill Veerappan. For me, when I hear the name Veerappan, the first thing that comes into my mind, which I'm pretty much sure is the case with majority of the people as well, is his mustache, that big fat mustache. Alright, now let's speak about the author, who is K. Vijayakumar. Vijayakumar is a retired IPS officer of Tamil Nadu who was leading the Operation Cocoon for capturing Veerappan. This book, Veerappan Chasing the Brigand, clearly depicts all the sacrifices and enormous risks being taken by the policemen, officials, and also some courageous civilians for capturing Veerappan. Alright, now let's deep dive into this book, and I'll also share a few content which is mentioned in this book. This book is divided into four parts. The first part is the making of a cop. This part of the book is mainly about how Vijayakumar became a police officer. When he was young, his father was a police inspector, and Vijayakumar always wanted to become like his father, a police inspector. He cleared his IAS exam. However, he did not want to go further with it, rather he wanted to be an IPS officer, and hence he went ahead with the training for IPS. The main part of the story starts when he gets a call from the CM, Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu then, Jayalalitha, asking if he can head the special task force in Tamil Nadu for dealing with sandalwood smuggling, and that's mainly Veerappan's case. And then this leads to the part 2, Veerappan Files. So this part is all about Veerappan's criminal activities which were conducted, and also the trials which were being done by the policemen, which all ultimately failed to capture Veerappan. Now, speaking about Veerappan, at a very young age, that is when he was just 10 to 14 years itself, he joined his uncle who was also involved in poaching elephants. And at a very young age itself, he killed people who were standing against his activities, and then later he started kidnapping politicians and other people for making money. Vijayakumar mentions that Veerappan was not a very charitable person, but he was a very generous employer. So to explain it, the closure of a granite mine in a nearby area led to a lot of people being jobless. So what Veerappan did is took these people and then requested and gave them job basically in his smuggling activities, that is for cutting sandalwood and other activities. One of the very shocking incident which I was not aware of, which was completely new to me until I read this book, was that Veerappan had killed one of his daughters. The reason being that the baby being very young, definitely, you know, she used to cry, and hence it used to draw attention, or it can easily draw attention of policemen, and hence in the jungle it was not easy to carry the baby, and hence he had killed his own daughter. Apart from all these which I mentioned, a lot more incidents have been quoted in this book in part 2 about Veerappan. Now, part 3 is about kidnapping Rajkumar, the actor. So I still remember that happened in 2000 when I remember seeing in TV about the news related to kidnapping Rajkumar, the actor, along with three other people by Veerappan. So part 3 is all about that. That incident had created a chaotic situation down south that time. And a few of the demands that were put forward by Veerappan for releasing Rajkumar were definitely a huge amount, and then making Tamil as the official or administrative second language in Karnataka, and giving justice to Tamil Nadu for the Kaveri dispute, Kaveri water dispute. And the major one which at least caught my ears and eye was that the rape victims of two villages, Vachati and Chinnampathi villages, they had to be given proper shelter. So the history behind that is, it is being alleged that the special task force, whoever went to capture Veerappan in those two villages, once raped women there, and hence Veerappan wanted these rape victims to get proper shelter. Now speaking about part 4, Operation Cocoon, which can also be termed as a successful mission or operation to capture Veerappan by the government. But before Operation Cocoon, there was another mission which government tried, and that was Operation Boston, which failed. That was basically by befriending Veerappan's wife and hence trying to reach Veerappan. But that failed, and hence he had to start with the next mission, and that was Operation Cocoon. Now, I'm not going to explain the Operation Cocoon in detail here because it is this part of the book that is the most pulsating and gripping one, and hence I don't want to spill away anything in this video. So I would definitely recommend you to read the book to get into the Operation Cocoon. Before you read this book, keep in mind that Vijay Kumar has deliberately obscured certain details due to operational secrecy, and we should definitely respect that. So if you keep that in mind and knowing that this book is being written with utmost accuracy and truthfulness, this book is definitely a mandatory pick. So that's about this book, Veerappan Chasing the Brigand. Until we meet next time, this is Navya signing off. Keep reading a lot of books and stay happy. Bye.